After studying this module, you shall be able to know about the photography and their enhancement techniques. You will learn about image enhancement as an examination tool. You will also learn about the use and importance of digital photography in document examination. Introduction. Cameras, whether they can be conventional or newer digital designs, are a necessity for document examiners. The clearest record of evidence examined can be obtained through the use of photography or digital imaging, that is scanners. Much has been written on conventional photography in the textbooks and journals. So the focus of this particular module will be on this area only. Rather, the discussion will be directed towards the new imaging technologies, where necessary contrast will be made between the digital and the conventional photography. In digital photography, different film speed, exposure setting and lighting condition all impact on the quality of the photograph. In the preparation of charts for incorporation in report or for presentation in court, a greater number of steps is required than in case of digital photography. Conventional photography is widely recognized as having the capability to capture minute details and subtle difference in color and contrast. It was mainstay of forensic photographers and document examiners for many decades, until the introduction of scanners and digital cameras. File copies of documents examined were traditionally made on the photocopier. However, now the resolution of even low-end digital cameras can be better than that of analog photography machine. There has been a general shift from analog technology to digital. Even copiers now employ digital system equivalent to those found in the scanners. Furthermore, the digital copier often functions as a scanner as well. Both form of photography can record a fine details in typewriter fonts. The type of printing process used on a computer generated documents and the presence of torn paper fibers in an erasure. Digital imaging can be used to prepare work charts to aid in examination and to create demonstrative charts for use in conjunction with reports and for testimony purposes. Today's digital cameras and scanners are an outgrowth of spy satellites used in 1960s and 1970s and the US space program NASA. The need of the programs led to the creation of charge coupled device, that is commonly called to be CCD. Initially, the CCD is a computer chip that converts light into electric signals and in image sensors for most today's digital cameras. The CCD has an array of light sensitive diodes known as pixels. The resolution of camera is a measure of the number of pixels. These pixels detect the quantity of light that hits them but do not interrupt the color of this light. It is only through the use of one of many different filtering methods that the color information can be interpreted. In most digital cameras, the color information is an interpolation of the information gathered from a single CCD array. Only high-end 3 CCD cameras are capable of returning true color information. Digital cameras offer advantage over conventional film cameras in some application. Probably the most useful advantage in the immediacy of the image. Now next we have cameras and scanners. The photograph can be viewed on, in most cases, a liquid crystal display that we called as LCD screen, or on the back of the camera as soon as the exposure is captured. This allows the user to ensure that the proper area of the target has been framed in an image, a problem not typically encountered in conventional photography. It may be difficult, however, to observe small areas of blurriness on this very small image. Many of the newer models have a viewfinder which to some extent lenses the problem. To access the quality of images, they can be immediately downloaded into a computer and viewed in much larger format. If an image is deficient in any way, another exposure can be taken. The images are captured directly to a digital format that can be processed with image editing software on a computer. Also, various attachment enables a digital camera to be connected to a microscope to allow for instant microphotography. Typically, digital models are somewhat smaller than most 35mm single lens reflex, that is SLR cameras, and certainly smaller than the large format cameras. This can be a big advantage when a camera is taken into field of a photograph cameras. Small portable scanners are now available, as well as can be alternative to a digital and conventional film photography. There are several companies that are now beginning to offer digital SLR units that look and operate much like 35mm SLR cameras, even using the interchangeable lenses. In fact, the setting found on many non-digital cameras such as f-stop and ISO are now also present on a digital models. Of course, one of the most practical advantage of digital units over film cameras is cost. Digital cameras do not require repeated purchase of film, developing chemical enlargers and darkroom equipment. The digital SLR models now addresses one of the biggest limitations of the past digital versions compared with the film counterparts: resolution. The newest digital models are capable of 10 megapixel or greater resolution, though there is some disagreement as to the specific value. Resolution in the 6 to 10 megapixels are generally considered equivalent to that offered by 35mm film. Until the advent of these multi-megapixel cameras, digital images could not be enlarged too much more than 8 into 10 size before they started to show pixelation, a circumstance in which the individual pixel element that comprises the image begins to show as noticeable squares. As the resolution capabilities have continued to rise, it is now possible to enlarge digital photograph with clarity equal to that of conventional film images. When photographic consideration regarding the use of digital cameras for forensic purposes is the need for micro capabilities, most mainstream point and shoot models are capable of this type of close-up focusing. If the camera is capable of macro focusing, it may have an option, a macro flash unit, since the built-in flash will be useless at macro distance. The forensic document examiner must recognize the difference between the optical zoom and interpolated or digital zoom. Optical zoom is a function of lens on the camera, whereas interpolated zoom is a function of a software and result in deteriorated image quality. Another consideration is the storage formats available with the camera. Most cameras can store digital images in JPEG format, but this compression method discards varying amounts of image information depending on the quality of setting. A much more useful format for maintaining the image quality needed in forensic science is TIFF, that is tagged image file format. While this convention also offers compression option resulting in data loss, its application in most digital cameras result in all information in each pixel of the image is being recorded. The primary drawback of TIFF image is their size. A high quality TIFF image can easily exceed 10 megabytes in size. This becomes important when considering the storage medium of the camera. A new format that is becoming popular for those seeking truer image reproduction is RAW. This format requires the information as it appears directly from the CCD. Consequently, it is not the subject of the color interpolation form is creating the other file types. Surprisingly, the RAW format often produces smaller file sizes. While some cameras have small internal storage capabilities, most storage is done with removable memory device, referred as generally a flash memory. These devices come in different format, such as the compact flash and secure digital and memory sticks, to name just a few. Many contemporary computers and printers now offers direct input from the camera, its podium or the memory medium. Another consideration in the purchase and use of a digital camera is the setting that can be adjusted prior to taking photograph. Some cameras offer a variety of features such as white balance, sharpening, resolution, image quality, exposure and the flash level. Similar options and adjustment are present in some scanner applications. Some of these options may alleviate the need to later employ enhancement techniques on the image with a computer imaging program. Now let us learn about the image enhancement. Since the image captured with digital cameras and scanners are already in digital format, they can be downloaded into a computer and enhanced using a variety of image editing programs. This process can be advantageous in many ways. With a digital camera or scanner and an image editing program, a computer becomes a powerful tool in document lab. There are number of procedures and techniques that can be applied to a digital image. These techniques can be applied for two reasons. The first is to aid the forensic document examiner in forensic examination. For instance, by separating an image into its color components, it may be possible to differentiate two inks that appear to have same visible color to the naked eye. Alternatively, enhancement may be applied to assist in presenting findings. For example, the enhancement technique described by Sperry and Tolwer can be used to improve faint images from electrostatic indentation impressions. Next, we have image enhancement as an examination tool. Various image enhancement and digital handling techniques can play an important role in examination process. The creation of virtual grid over a typewritten or computer printed image can aid in detection of misalignments by digitally overlaying and superimposing images using layers. The shapes of printed characters like stamps and seals can be compared. The layering of tools is also valuable when associating indented impression with their source handwriting. Specialized stitching software allows multiple images, such as those that might result from infrared examination, physical matching, or macrophotography, to be easily aligned and seamlessly stitched into a single image. In some instances, computer scanner together with the image editing software can be used to differentiate similarly color inks, such as black ballpoint, selective super saturation of individual color channels in the digital image can attenuate subtle color differences. By taking advantage of the various color models used by graphic software, selective color filtering can be used to isolate overlapping elements of a question document. There are just a few of the techniques currently being applied by forensic document examiner in the examination process, with new and innovative process constantly being developed. Now, next we have image enhancement as a presentation aid. It is not uncommon for a forensic document examiner to find faint indented impression on a question document. In some cases, these impressions can even be sourced to the handwriting that created them or deciphered as important relevant information. The untrained eye of a layperson, however, requires that this type of impression be enhanced for viewing. The Tolliver and Spray technique described in this particular module will deal for the ideal situation. Similarly, an overlay and superimposition of indented and source writing can allow the viewer to readily appreciate the relationship. The overlay and superimposition technique is useful in many situations. It can be used to show the relationship between residual marks left behind after an obliteration relative to the original document, to compare typefaces and to demonstrate a match between a signature in a cut and paste manipulation. In order to make such overlay easy to comprehend, the electronic images are often colorized so that one can easily discern one from the another. Adobe Photoshop allows the user to change the blending mode of each layer so that it affects the layers beneath in various ways. For forensic document examiner, one of the most useful settings is multiply. Using this mode, areas of a layer that are white have no impact on layers below. Color portions of the image, however, blend with those of the underlying layer. This allows the relationship between the two to be better appreciated. Distortions such as those resulting from page curl when copying a book or a general reproduction distortion can be compensated for using graphics software. This can allow the layperson to more readily compare different reproduction generation of the same original. The technique used to accomplish this can include simple transformation or more complex displacement mapping. These are often done solely for the benefit of presenting the evidence, as the forensic document examiner may have little or no difficulty in appreciating the relationship, even a distorted reproduction. Conclusion: digital photography and scanning capabilities have added to the arsenal of equipment in modern forensic laboratories. Continued development and improvements of digital image capturing and the increasing versatility of enhancement software will increase their application to a greater variety of document cases. Conventional photography still has its place in document examination. For instance, capturing images of digitally generated or reproduced documents created on a fax machine, computer printer, or digital copier is sometimes best done using conventional photography. The approach avoids any interference between pixelation introduced by a digital image capturing device and that of that document itself. For archival application, conventional photography prints are longer lasting than the digital prints on a computer printers, which can fade or degrade much more rapidly. Some level of familiarity with conventional photography will aid in producing good quality digital images. Many of the settings now present in digital modes or digital cameras such as ISO are simulated representation of adjustment important in conventional photography. Without a basic understanding of film cameras, the adjustment and options available on digital modes may have little or no meaning to the forensic document examiner. Now, let us recall what we have learned in this module. In conventional photography, different film speed, exposure setting, and lighting condition all impact on the quality of the photograph. Digital imaging can be used to prepare work charts to aid in examination and to create demonstrative charts for use in conjunction with reports and for testimony purposes. Digital cameras offer advantage over conventional film cameras in some application. Probably the most useful advantage is in viewing the immediacy of the image. The photograph can be viewed on it. In most cases, a liquid crystal display, that is LCD screen, on the back of the camera. As soon as the exposure is captured, this allows the user to ensure that the proper area of the target has been framed in the image, a problem not typically encountered in conventional film photography. One photographic consideration regarding the use of digital cameras for forensic purposes is the need of macro capabilities. Some cameras offer a variety of features such as white balance, sharpening, resolution, image quality, exposure, and flash level. Similar options and adjustment are present in some scanner applications. Some of these options may alleviate the need of later employ enhancement techniques on the image with the computer imaging program.